And a happy, happy day to you. Hope everybody's having a good one. I know I sure am. Let's see what Jesus has to say about judgment. A serious topic, no doubt. Jesus was talking to the Pharisees in John 9:39, and Jesus said, "For judgment I have come into this world, that those who do not see may see, and that those who see may be made blind." Jesus tells us here that he did not come into the world to execute judgment. However, the end result of his second coming will result in judgment because some people refuse to believe. Can you believe that? Let's look at another scripture where Jesus is talking in John 3:17. "For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved." Jesus came to inform the world the first time. He came to die for our sins so that we may have a relationship with God Almighty. When Jesus comes again, he is coming in judgment. He's going to judge everyone, but especially the people who refuse to accept that he is who he is. Let's go to one more scripture in John 3:18. "He who believes in him is not condemned, but he who does not believe is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God." To believe in Jesus is to receive him and to avoid that final judgment that sends you into the lake of fire eventually. You're going to miss out on a lot of things by not accepting Jesus Christ, accepting God, and accepting their kingdom, which is on this earth right now and being played out through people like you and me. As the light of the world, Jesus came so that the blind might see, and those who think they see will be made blind. The word, the scripture, it's very simple. And to people with great education, there's a conflict here because they can't make sense out of the Bible. Some things they interpret literally that are figuratively or spiritual. And people who don't have quite a good education may be a little more easily accessible to the word because they don't try to figure everything out and make one and one equal two. It's called faith. And I have friends who are very wise in the world, degrees from school, but they don't get it. They can't put it together. So I encourage you to just keep an open mind. You know, read the Bible yourself. Don't take what I'm saying as the gospel, although I'm trying to present it, and I think it is. But do your own due diligence because you are responsible for your soul. Remember, that judgment is coming. Gypsy Carnes, signing off.